Rockland County, a suburb of New York, recently declared an emergency due to an outbreak of measles, barring unvaccinated children from being out in the public to protect the community. Vaccinations have come under scrutiny in recent years, despite assurances from the medical community. As a result, some parents have not had their children immunized, but should vaccinations be mandatory? I sat down with Dr. John Snyder of Amherst Pediatrics, who shared his very own personal experience with the measles virus and his belief in the importance of vaccinations.
Well, in this case, it's mostly about, unfortunately, pockets of under-immunization. So certain every disease has what's called a threshold level of vaccination, so-called herd immunity threshold. You need a certain percentage of people immunized against the disease to prevent spread, should a person with the disease enter that community. And for measles, it's about 94%. So in other words, if 94% or fewer people in a community are immunized against measles, an outbreak will spread quickly should someone with measles enter that community. And so unfortunately what we're seeing is in certain communities, the immunization rate has fallen below that herd immunity threshold, and then we see outbreaks.
And in particular in New York, I know that they're dealing with this. Rockland County has had, I think, more than 150 measles cases, and they have now instituted sort of a ban of people under the age of 18 who have not been vaccinated from going to public places, which some people might call extreme. What's your view on that?
It is extreme. Unfortunately, extreme circumstances require extreme responses. And we do have an extreme circumstance where in that particular county, that immunization rate that I was just referring to, it needs to be 94% for measles. It had dipped to the low 70%. And in that case, it's a real public health threat. And it's not just a threat, it's a reality. So somebody imported measles from another community. I think that was probably in Europe, where there's even more of a problem with immunization rates. Somebody came highly contagious with measles and spread it through the community where the herd threshold was lower than it needed to be. And so you started to see an outbreak of measles, which is very dangerous.
I know as a pediatrician, you're answering parents' questions all the time. For people who are nervous about vaccines, and there have been, you know, some reports through the years that vaccines cause all sorts of different issues, including autism, which I think has been debunked. But people will come in, you know, with serious concerns. What do you tell them?
Well, it's important to listen to their concerns. There are a lot of concerns. Unfortunately, they're pretty much all unfounded. And we've all heard about fake news. There is a lot of fake news about vaccine risk. The risks of vaccine, there are risks to everything in life, but the risks ascribed to vaccines are either untrue or blown way out of proportion. For example, the measles vaccine. It's a live virus vaccine. It's a vaccine that's attenuated, so it can't cause disease. But it can give you a fever, it can give you a rash, it can drop your platelet count briefly, but it can't do other things. For example, it can't cause autism. Mm-hmm. We know that. We know that just as much as we know climate change is real. The Earth is not flat. So these are things that are scientifically proven, just like we know the measles vaccine does not cause autism. There's not a single case of autism that's ever been ascribed scientifically to the vaccine. And the reason people believe that is because of, unfortunately, a fraudulent report that was published in a scientific journal that was then retracted, found to be completely fraudulent. But the damage had been done by the time the news had covered that report and the fears spread. So we have people not vaccinating based on sort of myth. And that's dangerous, as you can see in this community.
And you also have a personal story to share, really, about the measles.
I do. Ironically, I partly became interested in the concept of vaccine myth and the reasons parents make certain decisions about vaccines based on a personal story, which is when I was a medical student, my very last rotation, actually, I was taking care of a patient with measles, who ended up dying from it. And then I, 10 days later, which is the incubation period, 10 to 14 days of the virus, I came down with measles and also nearly died from it. And in the process, probably spread it to many other people. And the Department of Health had to track every step I took. And from then on, I sort of became, acutely aware personally of how serious measles can be and became interested in why people choose not to vaccinate.
Okay, so speaking of that, I know that there was a case recently reported in the Boston area of measles, but when you talk to parents who are concerned, I'm just curious, what is the law in Massachusetts? Do you have to have your child vaccinated?
So there are really actually only three states in the country where you are required by law to vaccinate unless you have a medical exemption. By the way, there are very few real medical contraindications to vaccination. Massachusetts has what's called a religious exemption, as do many. So most states either have a religious or a what's called philosophical exemption. And all that means is you have to have a sincerely held religious belief that vaccination is against your beliefs. There are no actual religions that prohibit vaccination, but again, it's very simple in Massachusetts to just sort of sign your name and say, I don't want to get vaccinated because of my religious beliefs. And you do not need a physician's note for that. And that's a big problem. California recently got rid of its non-medical exemptions, and it's now only the third state in the country where only medical exemptions are permissible.
And when you look at the measles cases, this is the second largest outbreak since 2000 when measles had been eliminated. What does that mean, eliminated? If it was eliminated, you think, well, it's never coming back.
Well, most people don't realize that there's only one disease that's ever been eradicated from the face of the earth, and that's smallpox. Measles was eliminated from the Western Hemisphere in 2000. Well, for the United States in 2000, but it's not eliminated elsewhere. So all you need to do is, get on an airplane and travel somewhere with measles. Again, you are contagious several days before you are symptomatic. You have no idea you're going to be ill in 3 or 4 days, and you are at your peak of infectiousness. So you can be spreading it, and measles is the most contagious disease known to man. If you are in a room 3 days before you get sick with measles and you leave it, 2 hours later someone walks into that room, there's over a 90% chance that person will get measles if they are susceptible, meaning they haven't been vaccinated.